What's going on, Showtime?
I'm good. How are you?
Chilling, man. Chilling. So I know you're a big Cleveland Cavaliers fan.
Yeah.
Your thoughts, man. How you feel as far as the
It was tough. The matchup all the way around was tough. You know, Golden State Warriors are a team that you literally have to beat them on all sides of the court, on both sides of the court. You know, and they're very, very, very hard to beat. We were able to squeeze in one, but we weren't able to get another ring. So there's always next year, obviously. And I think the number one focus, the number one thing Cavaliers fans are expecting, hoping, wanting, as well as LeBron James and the entire staff out there, is that they come up with a better personnel. That way they're able to not only compete, but beat. The Golden State Warriors.
There you go. So your nickname is Showtime.
Yes, sir.
And you know, like the people that's named Showtime, but they're flashy. You know, for you, you're just rugged and raw.
I am who I am, man.
You know?
I get the job done. Sometimes it's not always pretty. Trust me, man. I like looking good. The next one, I will look good. But as far as the flash, I just hope that everybody they appreciate everything that I do outside of the ring for what it's worth. I'm somebody who likes to have fun. I don't do it loudly, boastfully, but I do enjoy my life, enjoy this sport, and enjoy everything that I'm doing. I don't know what I can do to add some more flash. You know,
it's the Porter way.
That's it.
One thing too, man. I don't know. We go back. I remember StubHub Center. I remember you used to be walking out there by yourself. Nobody knew who you were.
Yeah, man.
I remember back in the days and I said, what's up to you? And like everybody was passing you.
You know, the crazy part is I still will be by myself, but people will probably be grabbing at me now. I'm still the Sean Porter, same old Showtime Sean Porter. I go everywhere by myself and with my dad, of course. And we try to enjoy it. But yeah, like you said, man, much bigger name.
When did your fame take off? After the Broner fight?
Fame started to take off after Devin Alexander. After the Adrian Broner fight, it skyrocketed and hasn't stopped since. So.
I'm gonna ask you a couple questions real quick, man. Just give me some quick answers if you want to. Just Ward Kovalev.
Ward.
Triple G Canelo.
Triple G.
Mikey Garcia, AB.
Garcia.
Why?
I think that he is. He's gonna be more ready for the fight than Adrian Broner will be. Like I said before, man, I think in order for Adrian Broner to win this fight, he has to go old school. I believe that 2011, 2012, Adrian Broner beats Mikey Garcia. Handy. No problem. I believe that if that Adrian Broner shows up in 2017, he'll win the fight. But I don't see that happening. We'll see.
So you think he reaches peak already, or has he peaked?
It's not about him reaching his peak. It's about him not performing at his potential. If he performs at his potential, he wins this fight. If he doesn't win, it's very, very competitive.
No, you're probably tired of this question. Mayweather, McGregor is going down.
I'm not answering that.
Not answering that, okay.
Yes, sir.
All right, one last question.
Yes, sir.
What, one thing that they don't know about you, your fans?
Oh, man. I don't know. They know everything they need to know about me. I do a lot of karaoke. Going tomorrow night.
Karaoke, you said?
Yeah.
What's your favorite song, man?
What do I sing a lot? We sing, we do some New Edition, Can't Stand the Rain, Next.
Can you give a sample of Can?
We do a lot of Jodeci. Ooh, yeah. Thanks, man.
All right, man.